I grew up in a Christian home. I was raised in a small family church. We were there every time the doors were open. I made a profession of faith at the age of 8 years old. We were very blessed as a family. My dad had a nice job, so we had nice things. And as a child, I equated that with a cause and effect model. I was good in school. I studied hard. I got good grades. I thought that was how life went. I knew that God had blessed us. I knew that it wasn't just our efforts, but there was definitely part of my mentality that was, I have to work hard for God to bless us. So my whole life, I was very dependent on my ability to make decisions and the fact that I did good things and got what I wanted. And one of those things was a family. And so I met my husband, Matt, my senior year of college, and we got married shortly after, and it didn't take us very long to decide that we wanted to start a family. So I was incredibly devastated and disappointed that we struggled with infertility. It became an anger issue for me because I did not understand what we had done to deserve that struggle. And even after God in His goodness gave us Genevieve in February of 2018, I still struggled with holding this beautiful child and fulfilling that lifelong desire to be a mom, but knowing that my heart was still not satisfied. I was definitely still missing something. And so I just began to pray that God would show me specifically what it was, if I was not saved, that He would show me. And so that Sunday morning, I was leading worship. We finished the first song and we began to sing "It Is Well With My Soul." And I was so excited about that because I thought that would calm me down. I thought, oh good, that will make me feel better. And then we started to sing the words, "My sin, oh the bliss of this glorious thought. My sin, not in part, but the whole, is nailed to the cross and I bear it no more." And I realized in that moment that I was still bearing the weight of my sin. And so I did what I always do when I don't know what to do. I texted my friend Allison. And for the first time, I said out loud to another person, "I don't think I'm saved." And in a moment of clarity that only the Holy Spirit can give, I realized that my entire relationship with Jesus Christ was based on my ability to believe the gospel. It was a moment I will never forget. I prayed and I confessed and I repented of the pride that had kept me trapped for my whole life, trapped in this cycle of sin and works. I was living a works-based salvation. And once I realized that, once I confessed that, I did not bear the weight of my sin anymore. It was not mine to hold. It's His, He's taken it, and He's paid the penalty for it. And now I am free to live in what He has given me, and I am free to share that truth because there is nothing that I want more now than to share that truth.